here with our good friend Dana Bourgeois Guitar. Those are beautiful guitars. Where are they made, my friend?
Houston, Maine.
In Maine, actually, Houston grows down there for Maine also.
Yes.
A friend of mine retired, said he's tired of living in the same old sawdust shack. Back in the past, locked the front door, and it ain't been fine. He said, no more shack. Full time, Harvey. All right, ready, boys?
In the same South Dakota, no time to beat the boys. Alabama,
you know,
swap around Louisiana, Texas,
and living like the top of them, just like a
chip
in. Full time RV. Come on, John, move it up. John DePatie, here with Bourgeois Guitars, our good friend Dana.
just let John spin this thing.
Makes the amplifiers, boutique amps, all tube. They sound amazing, super
very
clean,
good.
Super
very
clean.
Good.
How's the guitar feel?
The guitar feels great, fantastic.
Yeah, plays clean, huh?
Yeah.
How are you
doing?
Yeah.
Rip that one up a little more. What is your company here? What are you guys doing here today?
I'm representing here the G-Lab. G-Lab is a company based in Poland, but I come from Italy, really.
Nice.
But and they produce top-level MIDI controller, pedal effects, and pedal board. This is my signature pedal board.
Nice.
Just presented in NAMM Show. And we also have a studio stereo preamp, great for guitar player, for every studio. With the same EQ section of Neve desk, and it's great tool for every guitar player. Everyone want to record professionally the instrument.
Excellent. Well, let's let these guys rip it up and see what they can do, ladies and gentlemen. Mr. John DePatie, and once again,
Luca Di Luzio.
I don't say it because I know I'm going to screw that up. Go ahead, hit it, guys.
Thank you.
John DePatie.
And Luca DeLuzia.
Thank you very much.
Mark, pronounce the name of your company for me.
Minerick. Minerick Guitars.
Minerick Guitars. These are really quite amazing. As the camera pans around and sees some of these amazing guitars. We're here with John DePatie today, and this guitar really caught our eye. We just had to see the man play this thing.
So, outstanding. Yeah, outstanding. We love it that he's here. This guitar, it's a huge visual, sonically amazing because of the large wood body, the chambering, the multiple necks. It's a lot of fun when somebody's willing to step up and put it through its paces here at NAMM. And surprisingly, you'd think everybody would want to grab and play it, but there's a fear factor there.
Not us. We're fearless.
No, fearless. And we love it. So we're glad you're here and getting some video of this. This is great. We love it.
Okay.
About 3 months on the inlay, 3 months on the body, maybe four. But I want to say it was probably overall, it took about a year in total.
Amazing piece of work.
Thank you.
Nice.
I got a quick question, if you don't mind. A lot of people, a lot of companies that are doing multi-neck guitars, they're just for show. They're for that one song. We're kind of priding ourselves on the fact even a triple neck like this is something you can take into the studio and record with. You've had a chance to play it. Would you agree with that?
I think so. I think it sounds fantastic, and it plays very, very well.
Thank you. Yeah. I think that needs to get out because most people associate multi-neck guitars as not a serious recording instrument or just, you know, messing around. These are serious studio instruments. They just happen to look like a Lamborghini. You know,
exactly.
But I appreciate you. Coming from you, that's going to hold a lot of weight when people see this video. I appreciate the time and the kind words.
Likewise.
You bet.
I got a woman way over time that's good to me. Oh, yeah. Well, I got a woman way over time that's good to me. Oh, yeah. She give me money when I'm in need. Yeah, she's a kind of friend indeed. I got a woman way over time. It's good to me. Oh, yeah.
These are the world's first circular and curved keyboards.
What a great idea. Have you thought of adding a bar to these? So we have a, it would be the perfect thing, wouldn't it?
We have the mounts for it right under here, ready to go. Drink holders included.
All right, perfect. Well, we have Jody Bagley with us here. He's going to rip it up a little bit and try this thing out, maybe dance a little bit while he's doing it out there. Come on, Jody, give us what you got out there on this thing. Yeah.
Never played a circular keyboard before. He's coming in here and he's hitting it right out of
that's
the gate.
That's right. He's never been on a circular keyboard before in his life.
So we have this thing. Keyboardists tend to look like gate entry professionals on stage.
Yeah.
You know, they're sitting back there doing
right.
the gate entry. This puts them in a totally different visual environment. Our circular version of this tilts forward 30 degrees towards the audience and you have a full circle of 288 keys.
Oh my God.
And it all comes out of one USB MIDI port.
Amazing. Amazing.
Fun stuff.
Yeah. Woo, that's pretty amazing.
So our keyboards are really kind of breaking the form factor of the keyboard for the first time in 350 years.
I love it. It's about time, right?
Exactly.
Yeah.
We think so.
Woo. Now, come on. Give us a bass thing over there and keyboard synthesized synth over there. Come on, split it up. Chuck, so much. We're here at the NAMM Show at the Reverend Guitars booth with Joe Naylor, who designed the pickups, I believe, on these guitars. Is that correct?
Yes, I designed the pickups and the entire guitar, actually.
Oh, and the entire guitar. Yeah, so he does triple threat here. As
I'm the founder of the company and the designer.
I would be solely impressed. I got one of their guitars myself very recently and haven't touched any of my other guitars ever since. So really wanted to come by. We have John DePatie here with us today. Great guitarist who's going to try out some guitars and just let it rip and see what he can do with these things. How
Sounds
long
good.
Have you been in business?
Well, this is actually our 20th anniversary.
Oh, nice.
Yeah,
Absolutely fantastic. Now, I saw some of your older guitars. I started investigating a little bit about them and, you know, your original guitars and what collector's items these are. You can't find them anywhere. It's amazing. Once people seem to get your guitars, they love them. So.
They do. And, you know, we have a lot of loyal customers and... that's what's kept us going for the last 20 years, and we're just happy to still be here and doing it.
Excellent, man. Yeah. Well, let's see what John DePatie can do with one of them.
It makes it sound great.
Absolutely fantastic. Well, I have one already and plan on getting one of each before it's over.
All right. You're our type of customer.
Thank you so much, Joe. Thank you, guys. This is Will Faber from Topless Records, and we're here at the NAMM Show with our good friend Ted from Magnetone Amplifiers. Tell us a little bit about Joe's story, Ted.
Magnetone was started in 1937 and was always based in Los Angeles. They made everything from radios that were all tube to record players. And Magnetone's biggest unique thing, I guess, compared to the industry's other inventions would be that we invented the vibrato using a non-moving part. So the vibrato is pitch, raising and lowering,
right,
versus tremolo, which is louder, softer, louder, softer. So Magnetone's pitch shifting vibrato, maybe you want to listen to it?
Sure. Yeah, let's hear that. Talk about our favorites. We better not talk about our favorites, obviously. But they've all been good. We've had a great time. John has ripped it up in all booths throughout, and we've had a wonderful time. So say hi to everybody, and we'll
hi, everybody.
Yeah, hi, everybody.